updated my custom playbook. I was using a custom playbook and I just got like, I have no real system with this thing. So I need a system. Need to build a system. So I just went ahead and scrapped that and start been playing last few games since that one. Playing with
EA
the
Sports. It's in the
Jets
game.
playbook. I like it. It's kind of round, well-rounded. The what? Niners? So you guys are in Oakland, right? Yeah, I'm. Cook is down at. Yeah, I'm in Madison, Wisconsin. Cook is down in Vegas, along with the Patriots owner, the Rams, the Chiefs, quite a few guys, actually. Yeah, well, there's just guys all over because I pulled this league together through Facebook. So, I mean, I had like our 10 guys that are Vegas, like centered, and then I had a group of guys that are from LA, and then yeah, other guys, a couple other guys that are from the where are they from? They're from other franchise leagues that I was in, and they want to try their hand, and I said, do $20, injuries off, which is trying to play it as like you're playing regs, but with a little bit of a twist. We used to have them on fourth down. Yeah, Cook's getting Bo Jackson on his squad though. Yeah, he's gonna have Bo Jackson. He's gonna have who else? He's gonna be the Raiders too. Yeah. Hopefully that updated roster comes out relatively quick so I can get to work. Well, I gotta put, I mean, think about it. I gotta put 62, well, not 62, at least 50 legends together. So, and there's gonna be some whining.
From the site that many call the loudest in the
Oh, yeah.
NFL, we are inside Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene
Yeah,
a few
well,
moments ago, here it is.
like I
It's
said,
unlike any other
this
in sport
way
as
you
both
get
teams made their way out of the tunnel. These
the
folks are
bottom of
fired up as their guys are
barrel
ready to
teams,
do battle
freaking
with Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers. That's fielded in the end zone.
Giants. That's nice.
And this return nets positive as
it's gonna be a good squad. Oops, there we go. Oh yeah. Well, no, you got Jabril Peppers. He's gonna, I think he's mid-80s. You mean Landon Collins? Yep, Landon Collins, yeah. Yeah. You're on a good pace to do it, and he gets angry, so that probably doesn't help his cause.
Gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line.
Ready?
Oh, trying to get that to Adams, but that's intercepted. Picked off by Bashaun Breeland, and they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line.
RPO.
Well, that's tough. You come in here, you dial up that pass play on the first play from scrimmage and get it picked.
And you know, coaches always talk about we prepare for every eventuality. You don't even mention this as a possibility when you dial up that play, right? Instead, they throw a pick, and now they're behind the eight ball on the road to get things going.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Slipping into the backfield for the sack was Oren Burks.
Okay, partner, a couple points of interest right here, all right? Offensively, we see that they came out throwing the football, but maybe more importantly, the blitz that came defensively, they got right after it.
And you were telling me pregame before we came on air, you think this is something we could see a lot.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it because this is a unit that wants to play the game on their terms.
After the sack on first down, Mahomes. Give him five on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On third and long, it's Mahomes. And it's complete to Kelsey. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal.
Get ready. Shift, shift. Check three, check three, check three. Right hand. Right hand.
They'll try and get it home with Sherman, the fullback. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Well, you've got to like that start on both sides of the football. You force the three and out, and then you score on your first drive.
Well, I know someone who doesn't like that start.
Well, yeah, the other side.
Yeah, they don't like that at all, right? This is not the way it's supposed to be. But what you just described, that's team football, all right? When you get a three and out, you're supposed to take advantage of it on the offensive side of the ball. You said, thank you very much for getting us the rock. Let's put it in the end zone, and they did exactly that.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Got to laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha. That was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
Tackle made there by Frank Clark.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, it's Jones. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Rodgers going to try and throw on third down. And he finds Jimmy Graham. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
And a key number on that play, three. Third play of the drive. Third down.
Oh, he went for the touchdown.
Spectacular catch. Turns into a first down.
First down saves him from a three and a. Oh, he tried to pitch it and the ball's loose.
Oh, my God.
But I think the Chiefs have it. They do.
Man, I just did a very stupid idea. And he
said, in the backfield.
The ball didn't caught. The pattern. It went off my receiver's back, and it was a backwards pass.
Act as his own blitz control.
Like,
yeah, he's got nobody else there to protect.
No one else there to protect, which means he's got to get rid of the football and absorb the hit. And now I just had this weird RPO situation.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Now here's Mahomes. Mahomes hit. He lost the football.
A place like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
He goes full extension, and he's got it. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. And that is going to be incomplete. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Oh, look at those moves.
They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. After the run by Jones, here's first and 10.
Check, check.
Open on the left side. This is Valdez-Scantling. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
From the 27, Rodgers. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. 22 yards there, a first down.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them out. And it looks like they did exactly that.
Yeah, going deep in the playbook and a great grab on the other end. Now Jones. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. They'll say no gain on the play and it'll be 2nd and goal. One back in the game. That's Jones, 2nd and goal. Throwing now is Rodgers. And he whips that one incomplete there. The veteran tight end, Mercedes Lewis, the intended receiver. But now it's 3rd and goal. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
They'll come out in the pistol. So it's 3rd and goal now, and this is where the Arrowhead crowd can make it very tough. Throwing is Rodgers. Got a man open. spin.
Wow.
It's Adams.
Shade.
Touchdown, Green Bay.
Well in this game.
4 yards on the touchdown grab as they are now on
next?
The board here in the first half.
I will post it. Give me a sec.
Boy, that route is really tough to cover because if they're running it correctly, you think it's really going to be a slam.
Yeah, well, we talk all the time about how it's tough to execute offensively, but you're saying, don't forget, it's tough to cover for the defense, too.
Yeah, the number one thing that you're taught is to not get caught inside or get beat inside. So you guard that a little bit more. So that gives you a little bit more space to operate outside if you start your move initially inside if you're a receiver.
Rob J. And he's a,
so all even at seven now as they kick it away.
Like,
that'll be taken in the end zone. They will take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line.
We may have, who knows, it may have to wait till the weekend. But he's available, I think, in the morning. So, yeah, we'll see.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. We've hit the 2 minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's seven. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. First down for the Chiefs, solid chunk of yardage, 17 on the play. To the right side, it's Kelsey. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Mahomes going to pull it out and keep it himself. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 23. Mahomes going to pull it out and keep it himself. And he's going to go down. He's sacked back at the 24. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Himself. That's caught left side by Hardman. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. The reception good for seven. It's third down. Williams. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the eight. Now another timeout. Called for by the offense. As the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Rashawn Gary, his second sack of the night. To try again after the sack. Mahomes, his throw caught at about the 5. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And the kick by Butker is good. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency break.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Preston Smith comes in for the sack. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Now a throw for the All-Pro Kelce is complete and able to get it here to about the 16-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Third and 11, and some extra depth to the secondary here. They're in the dime. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
They decided to take a shot and right down the middle of the field, and really, they didn't give it as much time to develop, did they? They want to take that shot somewhere around the 15-yard mark.
And the defense, able to recover, bat it free. And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on fourth down. 24 is the mark. They do go for it. It's Mahomes. Mahomes hit. He lost the football. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And now, boy, the ball's going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line. Breaking the huddle, first and goal as the return team has set him up with golden field position. Rodgers now to throw. That's complete right around the 8. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pick up a 3.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync.
Got a man open. It's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams, 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And once again, the Packers, they're back out in front. Crosby connects on the extra point, and the lead is now 14-10. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Now a hit and a loose football. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
How many times in the course of a game do you talk about momentum plays? And I think we just saw one there. Just scored, right?
Just took the lead.
Just took the lead, went downfield, got the ball free again and picked it up. They got a chance to really get the momentum on their side now.
And now they'll try to pile on. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
On second down, it's Jones. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's 3rd and 6. To throw is Rodgers. He sets up the screen to Jones. And they'll get this down to the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's 2nd and goal. They'll try again with Jones. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. A very valuable 9-yard pickup, but now they're set up a little better here for third and goal. So it's third and goal now, and this is where the Arrowhead crowd can make it very tough. They'll run it with Williams. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. It'll be called a gain of 2, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and inches. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through, and that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So that's a 7-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
Yeah, things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front 7? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We're back now in KC. It's the Chiefs with a football, but with work to do on the scoreboard, they trail as we start quarter number 4. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Mahomes now to throw. And oh, this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. That throw good for 4. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage is coming through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
To throw, it's Mahomes. It's Hill, complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Chiefs first down. Mahomes now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. A lane opens up that time as he'll be brought down just short of the first after a gain of about 9. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. The last run got 9. That leaves him with second and a yard. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. They run it again with Williams. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. The tally there, -2 yards, brings up third down. This is 3rd and 2, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Man open left side, it's Williams. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. A 5-yard loss there is going to bring up 4th down. Mahomes going to go on 4th down. Forced out to his... Oh, no, he lost the football. They've been burned twice already on 4th down, but the 3rd time's the charm as they keep the drive moving. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game.
Let's go!
So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Mahomes on target there to Hill. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
Talk about instincts and kind of intelligence. I think also the nice thing is just the continuity. When you play with someone for so long, they don't even really need to talk to you.
Yellow. You
know, exactly. You know, it's like in a marriage, you know, you know what you're trying to say.
40, 40, check, check. Watch 14, watch 14.
Off the draw, here's Williams. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And it'll be a third and about 13. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. So first and second down went the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and 13. Back to throw. And his ball is caught. It's a touchdown. And now in the final seconds, they're a PAT away from likely getting this thing to overtime.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
17-17 the score, all even to this point as it kicks away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They have a little bit of time here to get to field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with
you. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Rodgers to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. Now Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. That's going to be caught. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams finding the end zone on the game's final play. And they have taken the lead here in the final minute.
You know, the other thing about this Brewers team right now is, okay, for the division race, it's probably over because...
And with the lead, no chance of a return spoiling this one here on the PAT. It is up and through, and there is your final margin of victory is on the final play.